warriors who fought as members of the Dog Soldiers were the Cheyenne Nation's hope of repelling invasion. One such warrior was Roman Nose, Wu Kanil, or Arch Nose. Roman Nose was a northern Cheyenne who had distinguished himself among his people to such a high degree that the United States military misrepresented him as a chief of the Cheyenne Nation. Roman Nose was not a chief at all, but he was an influential member of the Crooked Lance Warrior Society. He was considered to be a superb specimen of the Cheyenne manhood, and was known by George Bent, who was also a member of that society. Bent described Roman Nose as a man of fine character, quiet and self-contained. At the same time, Roman Nose was a dangerous fighter who counted many coups against the grain, great prestige and high status in Cheyenne society as a dog soldier. According to Bent, all the Cheyenne, both men and women, held in highest esteem. Roman Nose established himself as a warrior following the Sand Creek Massacre. To avenge the death of the Indian women and the children at Sand Creek, an allied force of Cheyenne dog soldiers, Arapahoes and Lakotas, began in the early part of 1865 to lay waste to 400 miles of settlement. They burned ranches, farms, and telegraph offices, and drove off cattle. Denver was cut off from supplies and was virtually besieged. Roman Nose had come south to participate in the raids and rode with the dog soldiers, leading retaliatory strikes against the North and South Plateau rivers in the early part of 1865. The dog soldiers and Roman Nose's own followers created such a destruction on the Smoky Hill Road that it disrupted travel throughout the Kansas and Colorado area. The government demanded that the Cheyenne cease the raids or face extermination. A peace party between the dog soldiers and the United States Army was arranged on April 1867 at Pawnee Fort outside of Fort Lern, Kansas.